The Arrayites, Tales of 1001 Nights Volume 1. By Anonymous Author. Audiobook 37x79. You are the man who made a compact with me yesterday, how quickly you have forgotten me. He then removed his mouth veil, showing the beauty that lay hidden, and it turned out that here was Dau Almakan. Shurkin's pleasure at the sight was mixed with fear for his brother because of the thick press of heroes around him. There were two reasons for this, the first being that Dau Almakan was still young and needed to be protected from the evil eye, and the second that his life was of prime importance to the kingdom. So he said, "King, you are risking your life. Keep your horse close to mine, for I don't think that you are safe from the enemy. It would be better if you did not ride out from our lines, so that we may shoot at the enemies with our arrows that fly true. I want to match you in battle," replied his brother, "and I don't grudge risking my life by fighting before you." The armies of Islam then closed in on the infidels from all sides, fighting hard and overcoming their might and their stubbornness in evil doing. Afridun was filled with sorrow when he saw the disaster that had overtaken his men, who had turned their backs and taken flight, making for their ships, at which point a Muslim force had come out from the shore, led by the Vizier Dandan, the overthrower of champions. He fought with sword and spear, as did the Emir Bahram, lord of the Syrian provinces, with 20,000 heroes like lions. The Christians were surrounded, front and rear, and a body of Muslims attacked those who were in the ships, spreading destruction among them so that they threw themselves into the sea. A huge number of them, more than 100,000, were killed, and none of their champions, small or great, escaped, while all but 20 of their ships, with the wealth, stores, and baggage they contained, were captured. The Muslims won more booty that day than anyone had ever taken in earlier times, nor had anyone ever heard of a battle like this. Among their prizes were 50,000 horses, and that was to say nothing of the stores and spoils, which passed all counting. The delight of the Muslims at the victory and the help given them by God could not have been surpassed. So much for them, but as for the rooted Christians, they came to Constantinople, where the people had earlier been told that it was Emperor Afridun who had been victorious over the Muslims. The old woman Dat al-Dawahi said, "I know my son, the king of Rum, is not a man to be beaten. He has no fear of the armies of Islam and he